All right, ladies, so we're going to jump right into this look. I'm using my Juvia's Place palette for my eyebrows. I really love these two colors. And why not use your palettes more than just for eyeshadow? I'm a firm believer in getting the best use out of your eyeshadow palette. Original
Batman. It's VQ's.
Once we get done filling in our eyebrows, we're going to take the Juvia's Place concealer in color 13, and I'm actually going to line the bottom of my brows with the 13 because I need my entire lid covered. Then we're going to take the fond and put that on top of our eyebrows because it's more of a natural highlight effect for me. It's not too bright like the 13 is super bright, but that fond is a perfect shade up for me when it comes to doing my eyebrows. So we're just going to do the fond at the top and fill our entire eyebrow space up with this 13. You were singing along, you got me elevated like I hit the bar. 007, man, like James Bond. Me wanna get that feeling, something that give me that healing. Me, I don't want to tire, so me, I light up the fire. Me wanna get that feeling, something that give me that healing. Me, I don't want to tire, so me, I light up the fire. I, yeah, let my want a bad man, put a ring on it. Yeah. You are the only one me, I really gotta think of. Trust me when I say, you are the only one I feel for. So once we blend all of this out, we're going to go into our crayon case color. Y'all, I love this color brown. It is my favorite transitioning color. I know I try to use one palette, but something about this brown color just works for any type of look. So if you don't have this palette, don't worry. You can still do this look without this color. On the cruise control, let the vibes come true. Let's make a move on. Them really want to stress up on me. Bad man, them really can't stress up on me. So once we have that on our eyes, we're going to go into this darker looking brown color. It doesn't look that dark on camera, but it's slightly darker than the brown we just applied. And this is just going to deepen our crease in a little bit. We don't need it too deep in right now. So that's why I'm using this color just in my crease area. As you can see, a little bit, you can kind of tell that's a little bit darker than the original brown. That's why I say if you don't have the crayon case palette and you just have this one, this brown will be a good alternative to use if you don't have both of the palettes. Original, 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 original. So next we're going to take that brown color we used for our eyebrows, and we're going to put that in our crease area, almost right on top of that darker brown. I know it seems silly to keep piling on colors on top of each other, but when I was teaching myself how to do eyeshadow, I learned blending and layering really gives you a very different look compared to just using one color. So I like how it came out, so that's why I added it on top of it. And is it crazy how you can use these different colors for different reasons? I use this for my eyebrows, and you can see it gives you a totally different look when you use it as an eyeshadow. That's why I really love these palettes, because they're so versatile. What you talk about? I might not light you up. Next, we're going to take the lightest shade in the palette, and this is like a tan color, and we're going to put this on our brow bone. This is going to eliminate all of those harsh lines and everything that we put on earlier. So that's why sometimes it may look crazy in the beginning, but as you can see, this is really, really softening up that brow area. So me, I light up the fire. Me wanna get that feeling. Something that give me that healing. Me, I don't want to tire. So me, I light up the fire. I, yeah, let my want a bad man, put a ring on it. You are the only one me, I really gotta think. So we're gonna take my favorite primer, which is the P. Louise Rumor 2 primer, and we're gonna apply this all on our lid area. We're not gonna go quite all the way up, it'll make sense later on in the video, but I just want to make sure our lid area is filled up. You guys know my dilemma with my eyes, they're so small, so I kind of have to create my own area of space because I really don't have that much to work with, in my opinion. So we're just gonna add that to our lid area. Them really wanna stress up on me. Bad man, them really can't stress up on me. Now for our first chocolate color, we're gonna take this lighter chocolate color in the palette. I love this color. We're gonna apply that in the inner part of our eye, and we're just gonna pile it on. Don't really drag it over too much. It doesn't take that much effort. Just pile it on the inner part of your eye. Something that give me that healing. Me, I don't want to tire. So me, I like. Original, 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 original Batman.
It's VQ's.
After that, we're going to take this darker, bronzier looking brown color in the palette, and we're going to add that on the outer part of our eye. You can actually blend this with the lighter brown that we use because it's going to give you a nice little effect. And we're just adding this color because I have another surprise at the end of the video to really set this look off. So this is basically our background color for what we're going to add on top of both of these beautiful colors. Next, for our outer part of our eye, we're gonna do that dark brown again. Doesn't really matter which one you use, just something to give it some more depth and to kind of complete the eye a little bit before we add our glitter on top. You were singing along, you got me elevated like I hit the bar. 007, man, I James Bond. Me wanna get that feeling, something that give me that healing. Me, I don't want to tire. So we're going to use Burkina in the Juvia's Place foundation. A little goes a long way, y'all. If you guys want me to do a separate review on this foundation alone, let me know. I have pros and cons with it, so I don't mind telling you guys how I feel about it. But it really pretty much gets the job done if you need something that's really full coverage. But again, it also has its cons to it. We're going to take the 13 concealer because I think I want a brighter effect under my eyes. And we're going to mix it with our fawn color and just blend that out with a beauty blender. I got the money, so they sing for me. One for me, girl, she a one for me, man. Now if you lose control, you got the fire, can cool, let's get the groove on. And y'all, I'm in love with this Huda Beauty setting powder. It is amazing. I just love how it looks on brown skin, because sometimes setting powders don't really work for us. I'm not gonna lie, you have to always mix and match or find that perfect undertone for our skin tone. And this really works very well for dark skin. No matter what powder you get, I feel like all of them work good. Y'all, I'm still in love with this CoverGirl Queen bronzer and every bronze. I've been using this since high school. It's so hard to find these days, so when I find it, I buy a couple of them at a time. This is an amazing dupe for the Rihanna, I think it's called Stalker Sun Bronzer. In Mocha Mommy, this is the exact dupe of that. I'm telling y'all, I love using my old school products. It gets the job done. It's V-Kills. All right. Gucci on the Prada, send me feeling bad. I be looking like the nigga that you wish you had. Then my girls, then my coming, then my looking bad. Man, I'm rolling with my niggas and we moving mad. So me light on the pump, put it up till the morning. Then I know that your mind so they be stalling. And I be always there to answer whenever you're calling. And you always hold me down whenever it's boring. So sexy. When you think about add your liner, I'm gonna do this Too Faced glitter primer to add our loose glitter. Y'all, this loose glitter that I purchased from J. LaRue Cosmetics is amazing. This camera does not do it justice. I'm sure there's videos on YouTube about this glitter. I randomly found it on Facebook one day and was like, let me order it. Y'all, this does not do this justice. Every time I wear this in person, people stop me from across the street, across the club. They see this glitter up the street. It's that crazy how pigmented these glitters are. At the end of the video, I show you a low light version of it because you can't really tell on camera how amazing these colors are. Yeah, let my want about my put a ring on it. You are the only one me I really gotta think of. Trust me when I. So out of the slay stack that I purchased from the website, I used the color Flirt. And this is a picture or a video of what it looks like. They come in these little stacks right here and they're so amazing. I love them. Anywho, we're gonna add our eyelashes. These are just some regular eyelashes from Walgreens. Nothing special, but these are way better than the ones I had in my last video. On the cruise control, let the vibes come true, let's make a move on. Them really wanna stress up on me. Bad man, them really can't stress up on me. I really wanna test man for him. Bad man, them really wanna test man for him. Get that feeling. So yes, ladies, I still love my MAC Chestnut liner. It's the best. It goes with everything. I've tried different liners and I always go back to it. The two colors we're going to use is Bare from Crayon Case. This looks very red on camera, but it's not this red in person. It's more of a brownish color. I don't know why it looks red to me, but it's not this red. And we're going to blend it with this color from Crime Line. This quality from Crime Line is horrible. I just love how this color looks. It's called Shrooms and it looks very, very, very pretty on. But the quality is absolutely horrible.
love the nigga that to wish you hard. Then my girls, them are coming, them are looking bad. Man, I'm rolling with my niggas and we moving mad. So me light on up and put it up till the morning. Them I know that your mind so they be stalling. And I'll be always there to answer whenever you're calling. And you always hold me down whenever it's boring. So sexy, when you think about, I can't tell me nothing. What you talk about, I man, I light you up.
And we are finished. I'm cute. Yes, girl. I loved this look. It was so fun and so flirty. And my outfit that I have on is actually a swimsuit, but I just loved it so much. I'll put the link below to where it came from and everything like that. So here's the final look under low light. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure you follow me on Instagram and I'll be back with more videos. See y'all later.
Me, I don't want to tire. So me, I light up the fire. I, yeah, let my one time.